Hello, in this video I'm going to discuss the results of a short study I did on using different cell types in your mesh.
Before we begin, it will be useful to discuss a bit about the geometries of mesh cells. For surface, or 2D, meshes typically use triangular or quadrilateral cells. The surface mesh I created consisted of quads that were then diagonalized into tris. The reason for this is that the meshing software I use, Pointwise, will extrude pyramid layers from quads. If your aspect ratio is high, the pyramids become highly skewed, causing the inflation to stop. If you diagonalize the surface, Pointwise will instead extrude all types of cells and reconstruct hexahedron or hexes where possible. This was the method used to generate the mixed cell mesh. You can see that the leading edge area, where the cells are very high aspect ratio, stayed primarily as prism layers, but the rest was able to convert back to hexes. The other mesh used was all tris on the surface, and tetrahedron, or tets, for the volume. Both meshes were created from the same diagonalized surface mesh. Here you can see some of the mesh statistics. Please note that the CFD solver used was Fun3D, which is node-centered. Your results may vary with different discretization schemes. In total, 4 cases were ran, 2 for each mesh. 1 case for each mesh at 0 and 5 degrees alpha. The simulations were steady-state RANs with the SA turbulence model. The cases ran for 10,000 iterations on 40 cores. You can see that the TET mesh ran roughly 35% faster for both cases compared with the mixed cell mesh. Plotted here is the history of CFD runs for 0 degrees alpha. You can see that the lift and drag are plotted versus iteration. Below that, the diff, or rough derivative of the quantities, are plotted. The diff function is essentially just displaying the difference between the values at the current and previous iteration. And here are the same plots for 5 degrees. Overall, both meshes converge for lift similarly, but the all-TET mesh does converge quicker for drag. Due to the discrepancy in predicted drag values, the results were compared to previously published data. The results for each are relatively in line with the published data. The tetrahedral mesh is closer for drag, but this may be within margins of error. All data collected in this study suggests that the fully tetrahedral meshes should be used for future work. A limitation of the presented data is inherent in the method of comparison. The meshes were generated from the same surface mesh, and a mesh independence / convergence study was not conducted on each. Therefore, it is unknown whether benefits would be seen in either case from convergence at a coarser mesh when compared to the other mesh. To determine these effects, further investigation is likely necessary, but the fact that the tetrahedral mesh more closely matches the results from published data indicates it may converge earlier, but this is still unknown.
Thank you for watching. The final closing remark I would make is that there is some uncertainties in the results here in terms of which one's better. I would suggest that if you have a similar case to what I'm doing, which is just a full clean aircraft, no control surfaces, no propeller, nothing like that, nothing crazy, it does look like a TET mesh is working better. But maybe if you have a more simple geometry where it's pretty easy to generate those flow aligned cells, in that case maybe a mixed cell grid might perform better. I don't know, you would have to do a bit of a study. I will suggest it does seem the TET mesh does, and from some other testing with a few other cases, it does seem like the TET mesh does run faster at least, and does seem to converge slightly quicker for drag predictions. I made this video because I looked into the literature out of curiosity and I didn't see too much. So hopefully this video helps with that. At least it's a starting point with at least one data point when you're starting your investigation. You can use this. If you do an investigation of some sort, please leave it in the comments. I would be interested to read your results and see how they compare with what I did. And that's it. That's the closing remark. Thank you for watching. Please like, share, and subscribe. I really appreciate any comments on the videos, whether those are suggestions on how I can improve these videos, or just general questions on CFD. Please leave those down below. Thanks for watching. Goodbye.